Hi everyone, thanks for tuning in again. Over the next few minutes, I'm going to be showing you how you can put multiple charts on one page, what we call tiling charts. So you can have different time frames of the same ticker or different ticker on the same page. So I'm going to, from the welcome screen here, I'm going to hit the little plus sign up the top left there. It's given me a new page, and I'm just going to double click to bring up the security selection window, and I'm going to type in my ticker symbol, Microsoft, and that's put a daily chart on there. Now to put a chart next to it, on the left-hand side, I'm going to move my cursor to the left-hand half of the chart, right-click, go to the new icon, which is the three bars symbol on the left-hand side, and then select new chart. And that's going to bring up the small version of the security selection window. So I'm going to type Microsoft again, and then hit enter. And that's put a daily chart onto the left-hand side. So I can change that to weekly from the chart header there. I can make that candlestick. And also I can put on a tool. So I'm going to put on moving average and then right click on that moving average and change it to 20, like that. Now we can keep going. We can add as many charts as will fit on your screen. So I'm going to add another one, but instead of using the new chart option there, I'm going to select from the actions menu, which is the running man, clone chart. And because that chart that I'm cloning had a tool on it, the moving average, that's been included in this copy. And what that's done is created this floating chart over the top of those two. But as I click and drag the mouse, you can see the blue shaded area on the screen. That is where, when I let go of my mouse, that is where the chart is going to be placed. So if I go all the way to the left, it's going to overwrite the one on the left there. But let's put it down here into the bottom half on the left-hand side. Likewise, I can clone, even though there's no charts on the daily chart on the right-hand side, I can go to the actions running man, clone chart, and put that down there as well. Now, the software is smart enough to put them all the same size, so you don't have to worry about manually manipulating the chart edges. But what you can do is manually resize them if you'd like. Actually, I might do another example of that. So I'm going to click on the plus to create another page. Again, double click. This time, let's do CBA from the ASX. And this time I'm going to grab the right hand side of the chart and just drag it in a little bit to give us a blank space on the right hand side. No set size, it's just a random size that I chose. And in that white area on the right hand side, I'm going to double click. And again, you can see the blue shaded area. So that's what's going to be automatically filled up with the chart which I'm going to add. So this one I'm going to add XJO for the index. And again, I can grab the bottom of that, drag it up around about halfway, double click, and fill that space again. And this time make that a monthly chart and then zoom in. One other feature about these grouped charts, tiled charts, is that we can group them all together so that when we change the ticker on one, all three will automatically update. So that's this diamond grouping feature up in the top right-hand corner of the chart, or of each chart. So as long as they've all been set to the same color, so I'm going to set all of these to green, like that. So now, to update the chart, I can just start typing the next ticker symbol. So ANZ, and as you can see, when I do that, the in the top left corner, there's the small version of the security selection window pops up, allowing me to choose ANZ there, and as you can see, all three are now ANZ charts. One more final example. I'm going to remove the grouping for that bottom right hand chart. I'm going to change that one to XJO for the index. I'm going to zoom in and I'm going to change it from a candlestick to a GAN swing, so we get a bit more of an idea of the trend. So now only the top two charts are grouped together. So now if I change this back to CBA, the chart in the bottom right corner doesn't change. It's still locked at XJO because we've removed that grouping. A couple of other features with tiling charts are the magnetic edges. So what I can do, if I want to resize that main chart window, I'll just click and drag that over a little bit. And then I can do the same with these two. But you can see as I drag that and it gets close to that other chart, it snaps right to it with a magnetic edge. So it makes it nice and neat, doesn't leave any gaps. Although it is possible, if you wanted to, you could drag the chart over a little bit as well. But you can either grab that edge and it'll do it, or grab the header and move your mouse slightly. So click and drag. And again, that shaded area, so it's automatically gonna fill that entire space. When you see that. So that's just another way of moving charts and creating a workspace that you want to set up for all your analysis. Thanks very much. If you have any questions, as always, please let us know.